Don't forget to share your audio.
It's like he got the whole world in front of him, bro. Way he led the crowd on this.
Look at that. Sea of people, man. You know some white people in the crowd saying nigga.
They're like, I can't wait.
Hey. That part came when they had that comment. Hey, don't Red Tim's inspire though. You know, they was over there. Niggas wanna.
Everybody looking around because, like, I'll say it if you say it.
Hey, you
can't fight all of us. It's crazy. It's like we said it. See you.
Hey, man,
then you have it, met the eight.
Hey. Poop, 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 poop.
Ladies and gentlemen, y'all know what it is. The house of Coffee and Kush, best show not on earth. Moment of silence, lifting up our prayers and thoughts. Big X. Very, very, very sad event. But Earl Simmons, you know we're going to put on for you over here on the Speakeasy, baby.
Hey.
Celebrate, big homie.
Rest in power.
I never really thought all of these celebrities and idols' life will affect us so much. But then I just look back on my life, like 1970, 2021, I'm like, yo. For 25 years, DMX has been a very important influence in my life. And how, like this John, when this John came out, man, flipping and falling, I can't get up, bro. I don't know how many years I shed. And this is a young buck, man.
Right.
Like I cried to this. I'm like, couple years old. It's mind blowing. Thank you, DMX, man.
Thank you.
Not only did he show us, I don't want to say the way, but just the way he did it and operated as a man with his generosity, his care, his love. It's unmatched.
Like I was saying, fellas, to see all these stories coming out, y'all know, you know, follow Twitter heavily, social media platforms, to see, you know, ordinary people coming out with, you know, these random pictures of DMX just doing like just the most random things. But he was so kind, like to see him impact the people's lives, like black people, white people, Hispanic people, our Asian brethren. Like he loved everyone, and everyone loved him. And he was able to bring people together with his music, his passion, his soul. Like, I mean, this man was just, I mean, he was everything to us. He was everything. And I'm so happy that he's one of the few black men that got his flowers before he left. So I felt like he, once he did that Versus, I think he kind of understood how everyone felt about him. How happy we were to see him doing well. And, you know, we thought he was on his way to living continuing to live a full life. It's tragic to see that you know, what happened. Prayers and thoughts are with his family. Prayers and thoughts with his fans. The world mourns. We lost the king. There's no he in a better place.
My favorite thing about him is he was a Hebrew Israelite and he celebrated the Sabbath.
So I've seen multiple people actually put this in comparison. Do y'all feel like, you know, DMX wasn't, you know, the most lyrical person, but his emotions and stories kind of remind you of like an East Coast version of Tupac. Y'all agree with
Yeah, I saw you said that. I tweet on that all day.
I could understand.
Even Pac wasn't lyrical, but the way they told their stories and their emotions, you know what I'm saying?
Listen, bro, my man did a whole verse with rap with nothing but names. He did a whole, my man DMS got on a song and said nothing but names for an entire verse, and that shit was slapping.
Are you talking about Tender, Alicia, Keisha?
Listen,
he
did, it was nothing but names, and that bit was slapping. That's something that I felt like maybe only a Tupac could have
become. Can we play that song? I feel like we're going through all DMX's instruments.
Oh, it's coming. It's about
play that song. What these bitches want from a nigga.
Somebody let me know.
Dog. But as far as like comparing them, I think that Tupac was a better rapper, more influential, but DMX, I could see how you would say that.
Yeah, I feel like Tupac was the poetic version and X was the dog version.
Well, you like that, don't you?
E-A-S-T-K-E-E-O.
Like that, don't you?
I gotta get Beast Boy off this bitch and quick.
Man, look, we're not even gonna talk about that.
Like a thief in the night. My thief in the butt. You think of life, I'm thinking more life and stuff tonight. Come on, ma. You know I got a wife. Even though that pussy, I'm not gonna jeopardize my life. So what is it you want from a nigga? I gave you, you gave me. Bitch, blaze you, so blaze me.
Go, hey!
Hey, I used to listen to this album / song heavy. I used to pop up on it, so. Violins in the back, sound all angelic and shit.
All right.
Hey, you know what? Before we get too deep in the show, you almost thought you was gonna pause me, did you, boy? We gotta shout out Pitts, man. Our brother Pitts couldn't be here today. He's doing some elite dadding activities.
My man, today. For Father of the Year.
Shout out to my dog.
Competition, CJ, for Father of the Year. You got some competition.
Oh no, it ain't never competition, baby. It's all love. Hey, baby, hey, look, it's all. Hey, I ain't competing with nobody today.
Jump in
I just
here.
Celebrate that.
5 minutes. He on the road. What? I said, hey, we still should try to get him to jump in here. He on the road.
Man, that man is enjoying his son, bro. Get out of here.
But in regards to Father of the Year title, y'all know that resides with your boy over here.
Ron, I ain't seen him back. Listen. Ron, your babies used to be on every show, man. You just done fired your kid, huh? Ron will have a whole sports show with his kids right there in his lap, both of them. They be like, nah, daddy, he scored 23 last night. Not 22.
Hey, we raising many entertainers. They gonna Let's be like, go. I want to be on that screen too.
Let's go. I got to get my son, man, my oldest one. He wants that setup where, you know, he can play the game and record himself while he's playing the game and then have the game playing too. So we might have to make that happen.
He don't play computer games, do he?
No, I mean, he does. He plays games on, but I think maybe only games that he could plug in the PlayStation controller and use the PlayStation controller on the computer.
I mean, you know, he got an Xbox.
Ooh, what Xbox?
No, what Junior got?
What?
Got a
PS4.
Oh,
X PS4? What?
Yeah, you know,
he's going in.
You
got a
camera for that bitch. He can do it from the PS4.
We'll have to get that set up. But see, the PS4 in my living room. He's going to have to do that in his room. And I don't know if I'm letting him take my PS4 to his room. We ain't there yet. We getting that, though. But listen, son, when you turn 18, of course, and you come back and you watching this, remember daddy talked to you like that.
Why you squinting like that, Ron? You good, though?
Man, got 4 eyes and still can't see. God.
All right. That was
so bad.
I'm
sucked on a lemon.
We just started.
Y'all
ready to do the official
talking
start this show,
Paul?
When was I in the show?
Yeah. We ain't in the show yet?
Yeah, we in the show. We started it when we played the next video.
Man, you can
see
me.
You recording today, right?
Yeah.
I know, I was just fucking with you. JD got so lost in space last week. to watch episode 7 on YouTube.
Bro, it was already too late for me. I was like, you know, I'm gonna let this nigga keep going. It's already too late.
This episode okay. 8.
This is episode 8. Here we go.
Ooh, ooh. But we moving, ain't we?
And we getting through it, ain't we?
Ooh. All right, fellas. I need the congregation to repeat after me. So, weed is good.
Weed is good.
Weed is good. Weed is good all the time. Weed is good.
All the time, weed is good.
Damn right. Can I get a gram? Let the congregation say a gram.
A gram.
All right, let's get this shit started off right.
I love that, Joe.
10, 9, 8. It's time for the best show not on earth.
Who's our idiot?
Everybody's ready.
2, 1.
Woo! Yeah.
Let me put something in the air.
Sound like something great about to happen.
Welcome to Golf and Kush.
Something epic.
Shout out our sponsors, Pepsi, hitting us with them checks. Love it. That was a fun piece of the Make sure y'all subscribe to our Facebook group.
I'm gonna look a panda!
Please subscribe to the Facebook group. Instagram coming soon. And our very own YouTube channel. The coffee and Kush is just too much. We kept from the world. And y'all know TJ. Every show, TJ and I do. Y'all stay tuned to the end. Watch this mofo to the end. Chance to win $25.
Has anybody won that bitch yet?
And nobody won no free money.
Ain't nobody watching this shit.
That too.
You're
going to
find
out
who
it is. It's the hit. You know what?
Somebody's going to pick up to it. They're going to be like, oh, I can get $25 every Saturday. And we done after 4 Saturdays.
Right.
Like collecting these checks.
We done as soon as you're looking at me to put in the money in. That's when we done.
Well, yeah. Coffee and Kush Entertainment.
Off me a cushion to build.
You gotta
take mine up, you ought to. Is it just me or is Ron low? Like, I know you Ron low, but you Ron low. Like, you're low.
So I don't know. Like, this far from my mouth.
Then is it just me?
Yeah, like, it's like he's not. It's like he's, yeah, it's low.
Because I find myself every time.
Was it the music not too loud? Is it? Is the music too loud?
But I see, I hear you fine, dude.
Am I louder now?
Yeah, you. It's about the same, bro.
Say something now.
Yo, mama.
It's still low. I told you not to make that left. I told you not to make that left at Mars. I told you to come to the right with me, and then I told you. Hell no.
Not better. All right, let me try to change these settings.
I told you.
What about now?
It sounds like your mic not even working. It's like you just talking it to the computer.
You know why? Because it wasn't plugged in.
Right. Okay. I knew I wasn't crazy.
This bruh.
And I tried to tell you
my
this
mic
trailer.
Was not
said,
on this
know,
entire
I said,
time.
I said, Ron, your audio not good. And you was like, yes, it is. Yes, it is.
My mic was not plugged in the entire time. Didn't Thank you, CJ. You, back in the days, JD number one. Back in the days, we would just let each other go through the whole episode fucked up. So thank you, CJ, for fixing that.
Hey. You lucky he said something, because some people, when they audio fucked up, they won't go back and fix it to somebody else.
Whoa!
JD, you got something to say about how you felt about your audio?
Nah, I ain't even talking about that.
Hey, that's an inside joke, brother. Over my
head. Audio sound off now, bro. You good?
If anybody comes to the point of the show and knows what we're talking about, you're petty. Go ahead, Ron. We can hear you now. Go ahead.
Um, I don't know what I was talking about. We in the smoke breaker. I don't think really anything trending going on to talk about.
It's been a slow week.
Besides DMX. And I feel like we did him right. Y'all stay tuned for... Oh, I was talking about how it's COVID and we can't go to the movie theaters no more. And you can't go get you a big old soda, popcorn, and nachos and chill back with some peoples.
Oh, wait. No. Y'all movie theaters ain't open? Can't relate.
Bruh, what's it like going to the movie out in the A?
Oh, it's cool. Yeah, I went to go see Kong vs. Godzilla in theaters. I had to see it in theaters. But
so what, y'all gotta sit like two seats away from everybody?
Yeah, they keep two seats in between everybody. I prefer it. And I sit like next to this, like, cause I go to studio movie. Bro, I sit right next to the food, so that's perfect for me.
Listen, this new world we're in Georgia, where everything's still open, but they give you room. Like I always used to kind of dread going out because. Like, people just be too close. Like, I don't like that shit. People be right up on me. Like, that used to make me go into the club or the lounge. I just don't like when people being all up on me, you know, outside my wife or whatnot. So now that wherever I go, when we go to a museum, people are spaced out. There's no rush to take people. When you go to the movies, people are spaced out. You go to restaurants, people are spaced out. Everywhere you go, people are spaced out. Bro, I absolutely love this. I hope that we continue this whole social distance.
It only makes sense.
Post COVID, continue to do this. I absolutely love it. The world should have been like this. But you can stand in line at the grocery store
without getting hit by someone's cart.
Your arms all the way around, and nobody not right up on you. And then you don't got to cover your pen no more on the pen pad when you're putting in your thing because nobody right up on you.
Like even like when you go out to eat and you got your server with a mask, that only makes sense. It only makes sense. I don't want to talk about my food and spit flying off and, get into my shit. It only makes sense.
I love it.
Yeah.
I'm loving this new world.
Hey, so speaking of the movies, I just not thought about it. CJ, have you seen the movie Tenet?
No.
You need to
watch. But I've heard of it, though.
Yes. You need to watch that movie. That's what Denzel said in it. My man's nice.
I have heard of that. What is it on, man?
Tenet.
I got to take my notes while we on this. Y'all always be
giving. I don't know if it's on anything. Like you might have to rent it. It's worth it though.
Tenet? Did you like it?
You can get it on Tenet. I mean, you can get it on Prime or whatever you use. Yeah, I liked it. You liked it? You see it, Ryan?
It was fun. I guess it's like. A remix version of what's that movie that Caprio did? When he going through different levels of sleep.
Yeah. Inception.
Let me see what Amazon.
Yeah, it was a dope version of that. I've watched it. It's complicated.
You need to find it for like $3 or $4 sometimes. Just renting, man. Don't buy it.
That's what I'm saying.
I own it. I liked it. I own it. But
if you don't go get on Cody Firestick,
it's $6. To rent it on Amazon Prime.
$6. Are you taxed?
I've watched it 3 times and I still don't really understand the concept of the movie. Exactly. Right. I gotta watch it again.
How about one of y'all boys like screen record it and then send it to you?
we'll talk off air. We might be able to work something out.
Screen record it. Tenet! Entire movie live on Coffee and Kush next week. Y'all stay tuned.
We really gonna get this bitch spiked down.
Hey y'all. Alright, shout out to the best wife in the world. My baby say, did you need some more coffee? I said yes,
baby. It's Coffee and Kush, baby. You know what it is. Thank you.
I'm all alone. All alone.
Alright, I'm about to transition us and open us up to movie trailers.
That's the whole show.
I got don't forget Westworld, and I got a surprise segment for y'all.
Was there anything we're supposed to talk about? I don't think there was anything pressing, like, really.
Man,
like,
we've been posting. Listen,
DMX,
y'all got my messages this morning.
Oh,
I need that video. We gotta do the what's the segment we do at the end when we joining on folks.
Yeah, Ron. Ron, you gonna play that video, Ron?
I have no idea what y'all talking about.
Boy, if you
it's in the chat.
Oh, TJ, you know I don't pay attention to your messages.
We know.
You don't pay attention to messages.
This will say three things throughout the whole week. Then comes Friday, talking about yo, let's hop on a call.
We gotta catch up. What is this picture with y'all two on the wall?
Oh,
is that what y'all? Don't be no hey, bro. Hey, ho. Don't tell him nothing. That's what happened when you don't show up on time, Mr. CEO. That's what happened when the SVP got to do some things. That's let you know.
Sound like we got some new concepts. Oh, this lemon pepper junk. Turn this up.
I wish we could listen to the song. We pulled the bong out on this one.
Play this song, man. I'm about to try to find me one of them gravity joints. That's gonna look dope.
Ross did this 300 acres, crib on 2 liters. Shout out the boy in acres. CJ, I don't see no video though.
It's a Twitter link.
Josh on Twitter? Are we playing it?
What's the Josh on Twitter? Nah, it's the one with the it shows the dude's face on the left on one side and then the thing on the right.
Oh, with him crying because what they cooking on?
Yeah.
Oh, why didn't you just say that, CJ?
Man, you know what I heard, bro. So Eddie Griffin came to Atlanta, and he was here from like March 25th all the way to like last weekend.
Damn.
And I wanted to go, you know, he was performing at the comedy club, and I wanted to go see him. I just could not find the time to go.
Hurt That's my crazy.
Heart. He was here,
Eddie
bro.
Griffin like coming to my city.
Top
There's
five.
No way I'm missing it.
Top five all time to me, bro.
You seen his latest one that was on Amazon?
Mm-hmm. No. Yeah, he's shout out to Eddie Griffin.
CJ, why you wanna play this video?
Huh?
Oh, you don't understand English no more. It was always me versus the world.
Until I found it's me versus me.
Bro, you saw the video that I posted in the group, the chat, the one I said we gotta play this with, the funny one.
With the dude watching the food,
right? You said why? Cause yeah. It's freaking hilarious. That's why.
All right,
because listen, bro, we listen to our lawyers. So if you cool enough to have been invited to our chat, Coffee and Kush, exclusively on Facebook, you would notice when I posted that one, that got more laughs and likes than any other post on our group.
Shout out to our group, baby. Exclusive invitations only.
Exclusive.
You know, we're gonna get the IG growing, and that's gonna be the platform we let get huge. But that Facebook group, only the homies, bro. You gotta be Coffee and Kush homies. I invited some of my boys to that joint, saw them up in there laughing at all the hilarious shit. I was like, winning. I get that sound effect.
Mm-hmm.
You got it, Ron. You can play the video. I've been trying. Shit.
I don't know how Drake keep doing it, man. It's not fair, Drake. My man come out with an album with 3 songs on it, and it's the best tape I done listened to since Nas. It's crazy. I look like
to the homeowners with the girls, whatever.
NBA hook, whatever. Shit. All right. There you go, CJ.
We could have waited till we were supposed to play that at the end during the Jones segment, man.
Y'all gotta stay tuned. Psych!
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 Y'all like how we do that. Y'all stay tuned to the end of the show. Maybe we can make that the question giveaway. So we about to get ready to go to these movie trailers. Matter of fact, I know exactly when we're gonna play that segment. We're gonna go live on the Coffee and Kush page. We're about to go live on the Speakeasy page, y'all.
All right, man.
Just to intro and walk into the movie trailers, and then we'll get off of here.
You said what?
We're live on the Speakeasy or live on the Coffee and Kush?
We're gonna do both today.
Okay.
Yeah, we stepping up. Y'all over here dancing in the videos, shaking and wilding, showing off. Hey. But over here, oh, we ain't even live yet. Damn, I'm tripping.
All that cash money.
Hey, I was gonna get y'all. I was gonna say, since y'all two the producers, I was gonna say, Denny the one. You're the one you was just talking about dancing in the video.
Right.
That's definitely me. That's why I love it so much. That's definitely me. All right, now we about to go live. Danny, give us something to eat with. Oh, perfect. How's that?
Yo, what's good?
Good.
Look, it's Denny, the Coffee and Kush takeover.
Denny looking down like they can't see him. They see you, baby. Look up.
Yeah, you on there. Good morning, people. It's Coffee morning. And Kush. Wake your ass up.
He barely woke up.
He in the building.
He barely woke up. Talking about wake your ass up.
Hey, I slept in this morning. It was good. Best show not on earth.
My man say, what time we going? Now, listen, y'all. It's like, what, 9? 9:10. My man say, what time we potting? We say 10 o'clock. He say, okay, good. Back to sleep. I go like, oh, wait, where we go? An hour later, here we go.
Right. Come on, send the link now.
Then we'll go rushing to like, bro, you don't get on.
Hey, I'm on mountain time. Hey, good morning, Lynn.
Shout out to the homie. What's up, Lynn?
Hello.
So, yeah, Lynn about to become part of the show, man. She got
right.
Speaking of, Lynn is doing a special Mega Mug giveaway. Y'all link in with her pages. Exactly. But Coffee and Kush, we enjoying the day. We miss show right now. And we just came to say what's up. See how y'all doing. We about to continue our show. Space movie trailer adventures. We got like 8 new movie trailers we about to watch. It's ridiculous, y'all. It's ridiculous.
A lot.
That's when y'all can, you know, hop in and say something. But make sure y'all tune in Monday.
I'm all the way gone, bro.
I'm trying to keep it moving with the music. I'm on the ones and twos.
Moon, baby.
I'm on the ones and twos over here. You know.
Monday morning, all podcast platforms. Wednesday morning, please go support the YouTube page.
Hopefully.
It's Coffee and Kush, baby. It changed your whole day.
Hey, y'all be watching our video. And watch our video.
$25 Cash App giveaways every episode, but y'all got to tune in.
Say it again. Say it again.
$25 Cash App giveaway at the end of every episode.
Anytime you see CJ and Ron together, please believe it's a $25 giveaway coming somewhere.
We setting it off. Hey, Sunshine, the queen in the building. Lynn said, Kush. Kush. The Kush. So, before we get out of here, what trailer are y'all most excited to watch today? Ashley Pitts. She like, where is EP?
Represent EP.
I'm looking forward to that Saw trailer, actually.
Yeah, that's what I was getting ready to say.
Oh, yeah.
Saw
me. Dang. That's the unanimous number one. Sunshine said, I'm going to take that giveaway.
Oh, wait. What's the stipulations? You cannot win if you are on the show. There
you are.
You got to be a lawyer to win. Not to say you can't be a lawyer and work for the show, but if you work for the show, you can't win the $25.
Dang, CJ literally just came up with that stipulation off the top of the head. He pretty much said, Sunshine, you ain't getting a dollar!
That's fast talking.
Oh, man. So, that's all it is. Thank you, y'all, for watching our little quick live video on the page. Ladies, the queen represented. All the queens, shout out to y'all. Y'all have a beautiful Saturday. We're going back to our show.
I'll be in Kush, ladies and gentlemen.
You still alive?
Nah, we are. But they like how we just pulled up live on Facebook real quick. Go ahead and sleep on the house of Kush.
The house of
Kush. You know what I should have said? I should have mentioned how if you ain't in the club, you ain't cool. Maybe next week.
Like, when you think about shit after the fact, like, damn. I be doing that all the time with the pop. Like, damn, I should have said this. Doing the pot. Oh, shit. Sometimes I just be too
loud. So, we watched that video of the dude watching him cook on the toilet. I'm going to take us live on our page. So, get y'all thoughts ready.
Ain't no thoughts.
I was leaving gaps open for y'all to jump in. Well, I just be like, JD was like, nigga, what you doing?
Hey, I'm on the ones and twos, baby. That's all I do.
I push
buttons.
What's our first movie? Are we gonna Puff Puff pass him?
You can't, I got them all.
Puff Puff, give nephew.
Hey, we not gonna talk about Snowfall?
Oh yeah, we supposed to do our recap every week. Let's do it.
We can watch the trailers first though. How many y'all wanna do?
Let's do that now. That's better for the smoke.
You wanna get one trailer in and then because we got so many, just to keep bringing them, up.
But we gonna Puff Puff pass them.
Okay.
If we all three wanna watch it, I guess that'd be the vote. Majority rules.
No, I think we should do we say 2 out of 3.
So at least two of us gotta say yeah. I like
it. Right. Because I don't want y'all to not be able to watch a trailer on my account, you know? If I say no, y'all be like, man, get your.
So, before we get into our movie trailers, episode 7 reaction. JD, you still ain't watching Snowfall yet, is you?
That's what I was just about to ask.
No, sir.
Tragic, sir. You're doing yourself a disservice. But I guess you feel that way about me with Injustice or what's Invincible or whoever's name
is. No, he doesn't. He doesn't even have those feelings. Because he would have got mad when we was telling you to watch it last week.
I did watch it.
Exactly. But I get mad when JD say he ain't watched Snowfall yet. I'm like, how are you not watching Franklin say?
I don't watch a lot of TV.
Okay, my initial reaction, I'm so happy that he was able to put together that old girl was getting over on him. And I was mad. Like, I was like, why? I didn't think that...
I know you saw the meme. I saw it of him when it was like Franklin at this point is when he officially caught on to her bullshit when he was listening to her like this. Did you see that one?
Oh, I did.
Bro, the scene when they was outside the hospital and him and Leon was talking. I'm like, yo, she keep getting this man's affairs and business like out of nowhere because fanboy is pushing her. She come walking up on a meeting out of nowhere. He's just like,
like, what are you doing? Like,
what's up, Peaches? What's up? You got a plan, Peaches? I don't even listen to my own team's plans. You got a plan, Peaches? Yo, so on a serious note, when my man's girl, what's it, Jerome? Jerome, when his wifey got shot.
Right. That was sad.
He went nuts.
But Buddy
was like, Leon was like, it's so fresh in my head. Yo, that episode was 10 stars. JD, I don't know what you're doing. Leon was like, yo, Franklin said we got to stay at the hospital. He was like, crying and laughing at the same time. And then he was just like, what? Oh, man.
Fuck Franklin, bro. When he showed his acting skills on that motherfucker right there, bro. That nigga at his ass off. Oh, my goodness. I was feeling that shit, bro. My heart.
I know
he was holding him, and when he was like, like when everybody was just standing there in shock, he was like, motherfucker, go call 911. Like, go get the ambulance, bro. I felt like, oh my God, bro. If like I put myself in that situation, like me holding my old lady, bro, something like that happening to her. Oh my goodness.
We still got like 3 more episodes left. It's Snowfall already critically acclaimed by the Coffee and Kush team. 10 out of 10 for y'all. We got to get the director. Applause to y'all. JD, it's up there with like The Wire and Power. It might be better. Snowfall at the end of the day,
you know what, I is better than The Wire and never Power. Seen The Wire. I've never seen The Wire. Everybody gets on me when I tell them that too. I've never watched The Wire.
So JD, this is your John Rose shoulder.
JD, can I tell you something, sir?
What?
I'm also in that category, what you said.
Oh, I don't feel bad. Yeah, I mean, everybody gets on me. Like, I know I heard it's a really good
show. I have seen multiple episodes of The Wire.
I've seen
watched The Wire.
Yeah.
You know, the dopest thing about The Wire is I don't think they really have season 3. Might be the dopest season, but it's more of specific episodes throughout the 5 seasons. We should have like the top 10 Wire episodes one day and just watch a clip of it and see if y'all like some of them. But y'all like The Wire. Is Michael B. Jordan one of y'all favorite actors? Do you love everything that Michael B. Jordan's in? Then you're going to love The Wire when he first started.
I'm not going to say love, but I do. Right. Fucks with Michael B. Jordan.
Name something Michael B. Jordan was in that you ain't fuck with. I'll wait.
I haven't watched that movie, the latest one he did. That's on Netflix.
That's gonna be nuts. Tom Clancy. What's it called? No Remorse. We watched that trailer.
What's the movie he has now where like it was another one, you know, black people just getting shot by the police or something like that. Like,
oh,
it's a movie.
Mobile Station?
Yeah, there you go. I'm not watching
that. Yeah, I haven't seen that. I didn't want to watch that.
I'm not watching that.
It's so good.
I know.
It's so good, man.
Let me guess. Okay. Let me guess what happens. Some injustice happened, and in the end, it ain't no real resolution. Did I get it right?
The cop said he thought he was reaching and shot him with his taser. Nigga, you know the difference between the weight between a taser and a pistol. You know the difference. Nigga, you know what you're doing.
Either way.
All right.
But back to Snowfall, though. Get, you know, brilliantly written show. Love the direction is going. It hurts me. Hey, bro, what about when Teddy snorted the powder, right? And then he walking around in that jungle. And then he get his ass knocked out. He on the ground crying and shit. I was like, damn, he's losing it, bro. Like, he's losing it.
I'm so sick of his shit, but he Listen, carries the show.
I was with part also got my heart when Alton punk ass, Alton, when he comes in and basically tell his wife, like, I'm fleeing the country. Got the passports ready.
I did the best thing for you, my family, and everybody. And what I'm going to do is dip out on all y'all. It don't kind of go together, Alton. It don't.
But
he ain't say, I got a ticket for you and Franklin. We out of here. At least ask him or nothing. He's like, baby, let's go.
Let me tell you this. I will say this, though. That's probably the option that I would have went with if that happened to me in real life. I'm out of here. Not me being a snitch, but just if that shit went down, like let's say if my son was to live that life and I'm his daddy and this shit was to go down, I'm out. You say we got Will? What's my name? Jorge?
You want to know who Alton is, JD? Matter of fact, I got to find the image now and throw it up. You remember Paid in Full, right?
Vaguely.
Oh my gosh. Let's go to movie trailers. JD, I don't know what's going on your head. He said vaguely. Do you like Scarface?
Yeah. Scarface, okay. Shadows,
Godfathers. Because I'm starting to think this ain't your genre of show, which is cool.
Godfather.
Weird. CJ, have you watched The Godfathers?
I have, sir.
Okay. JD don't sound like he has. So I'm going Black Woods.
You know what movie I just watched for the first time, though? Matter of fact, bro, we was in Denver. It was Goodfellas.
You watched that?
Yeah, you was, yeah, you know, I was with y'all. You was in there all the way knocked out.
I was in a coma.
Because, you know, I had to get up for work anyway. So I was up and I put it on.
Morning flick.
And at the end of it, I was like, why the hell have I not watched this movie? This is freaking great. It was a great movie.
Classic. Godfather 1 is the best movie of all time.
But before we do, it also made me, just to kind of get a little deeper, but it made me think, like, damn, what if we had would have black people stuck together like that? Like, if we had that kind of pride in our family and ourselves, and we just decided that we was going, and I don't want to use the term mafia, but what if we had a setup like that? When we protected
biggest threat to the world is that dream and vision. You know, CJ, do we got it ready? Because I'm about to rant.
Not ready.
Let's go.
JD started eating over there.
He went
to the movie. So what movie? We got Puff Puff. Oh, is this Saw? We got Puff Puff Pass It. 2 out of 3, y'all. I think this is Saw. We all said 3 out of 3.
Yeah.
I can't believe Chris Rock is in this. Shit's nuts.
Play me.
Hello, Detective Banks. Do you know where your officers are?
Jigsaw?
Wait, I thought the Jigsaw killer was dead.
He is.
Find him. There are hours, not days.
How can I catch this guy? If there's nobody on the bus, I can bus!
You can't do this alone.
Whoever did this has another motive. Something personal.
When was the last time you saw your father?
Jigsaw copycat.
This is gonna go sideways fast.
I'm a man, spin like a spiral.
All available units, officer down.
That was just a diversion to get us out of the precinct.
Spiral, 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 spiral.
I need everyone on this case. He could be anywhere. He could be anyone.
We're gonna tear this city apart.
I'm a man, spin like a spiral.
Hello, Detective Banks. When was the last time you saw your father?
I'm interested in seeing it. I wish they would do like that to all the cops that you know what I'm saying, that be fucking with people. I like it, man. And shout out to Chris Rock, man. My man started as a crackhead playing Pookie. You know what I'm saying? I gotta have it to you know, executive producing. You know what I'm saying?
Circle.
Yeah. So I'll support it.
I'm gonna be real with you. That didn't seem like it was going to be all that good to me. But I am going to watch it because Samuel L. and Chris Rock are in it. That's why. So I'm going to support it. Okay. But I didn't. There was not a part I'm like, oh, well, I got to see this. Mm.
Oh,
man.
What about you, Ron? What you feel?
I need a sound effect for that.
Huh?
Oh, and I thought that they was trying to set up Samuel to be Jigsaw. Now, if that would have been the case, I'd have been like, yeah, sign me up. But...
you never know. I mean, there might be a twist in there. You never know.
You're right. Wow. I might have just figured it out. But we figured shit out for y'all here. This is what we do, baby.
Hey, my man, Chris Tucker, he went to the future. He seen the movie already.
Listen, bro. Listen. Call me Flash.
So, it's crazy that CJ, you felt the way that you felt. One second.
Nigga always started shit so dramatic.
No,
I'm just behind the scenes producing and stuff.
Setting us up to look at his official picture. Oh, there it is.
So my initial thoughts is, like you, like this is not it. This is, as he was saying,
whack.
But then it got Chris Rock and Samuel Ewan, and I'm just like, is this Saul? What the hell is going on? And I'm like, oh, Hollywood had a dying series and they brought the black men in to come and save it. Makes perfect sense. So the trailer was whack, but there's no way we're not going to be able to go to the theater and watch these two mofos act their asses off. And we're just going to be like, wow, that's why we love them. If Chris Rock ends up being Jigsaw, which is my thoughts the entire time watching. He said, we gon' tear this city apart. I was like, okay, Chris Rock. My second thoughts is Chris, go ahead.
No, go ahead, you got it.
Chris Rock, you know, has the opportunity to do something different with his career in regards to the echelon of top black actors, because he's already killed comedy. Like y'all talked about him, what was his name, Pookie? I think he should switch up his roles in movies that he play and take on more of a serious, hardcore acting drama type route for a while. I think this suited him. I liked him in there.
Word.
If Samuel doesn't end up being Jigsaw.
You think it's Samuel?
If he doesn't.
Two times way down.
They gonna be like Jigsaw, we found you. Motherfucker, what? These goddamn snakes on these motherfucking plates. Jigsaw, why are you screaming?
I wish I had more fingers so I could get them titties four thumbs down.
Oh man. What's the name of this Joan? Is it Saul 10?
Spiral from the Book of Saw, official trailer.
So funny Saw movie before we go to the next one. What is it? So I can get the picture ready.
Who? What?
What's the next trailer?
Oh, where do you want to take it? We got this Ghostbusters 3 Afterlife trailer. He said you're not excited
for it? So as y'all is talking about movies that y'all have never really seen, I've never really fooled Ghostbusters.
Figured that. You know, it's before your time. That's okay. That's what it is.
I don't got nothing to do with it. I think it's...
That's what it is, bro. I'm respecting it, man. I'm not saying that. It's not that I wasn't saying anything bad.
I don't think Bill Murray's ever really made me laugh, except in Space Jam.
Bill Murray funny.
White guy funny. Our version of Will Ferrell.
Are you saying Will Ferrell's not funny?
No, I didn't say Will Ferrell was, and I said Bill Murray. Yo, I completely forgot what I was doing. We about to go.
I told
to-
you, bro, and you still didn't come back when we was. See, me and JD, we lost together, but at least we together. All right. You all over there to the left. We don't even see you no more. This is I say that JD gone. He to the yeah, he I went did, to the
Finn. Finn went in charge. It is right.
Ain't no charging in space, Dean. I told you about that.
I literally forgot what I was about to. I can't find this.
That shit happened to me earlier. Mid conversation too.
Oh well, going with those thoughts. You know why? It's because CJ always talking shit. Making me track of thoughts.
Hey.
So I will vote to. Ass.
Who are you voting with, CJ? CJ left us.
Who are you gonna call?
All right.
Hey, what you vote for that Ghostbuster?
Heck yeah, let's go. All right, but you know what? Because me and you talked about this before I see you.
We're gonna get that bit fired up right now.
Right, let's go.
Who are you gonna call? Ghostbuster.
Mama.
Better call Tyrone.
How we do? Hey.
JD forgot they had a movie trailer ready, y'all.
No, I had it ready. I had to go back and turn the music down before I start sharing it.
JD making ups. I had it ready. Oh, they got my guy in there. Okay, I'm in.
Chimoka. Strawberry, red velvet, blue velvet.
Somerville anyway.
Honestly, my mom won't say it, but we're completely broke. And the only thing that's left in our name is this creepy old farmhouse our grandfather left us in the middle of nowhere. Why'd you bring me up here?
Entertainment value.
What is that?
I don't know.
Somehow, a town that isn't anywhere near a tectonic plate, that has no fault lines, no fracking, no loud music even, is shaking on a daily basis.
Under the dining table now!
Hey, remember that one summer we died under a table?
I found this in my living room.
Whoa, killer replica.
A replica of what?
A ghost trap? There hasn't been a ghost sighting in 30 years. New York in the 80s, it's like The Walking Dead. Your dad never mentioned this to you?
It's just my mom. My grandfather died. My mom says we're just here to pick through the rubble of his life.
Wait a minute. Who are you?
Call it luck. Call it karma. I believe that everything happens for a reason.
Come on, darling.
It has a gunner seat?
So much action, but I like the action.
Wag. I ain't feeling this one, man. It might just be me being pessimistic today, but I'm not feeling this at all, bro. One, the first scene, Ron, that was the funniest part to me, was what you said. I can't believe what the hell I just watched. That shit there had me dying. I had to mute myself.
Stop hilarious.
Laughing too hard. I ain't want to ruin it for the rest. I mean, it looks like it's gonna be okay. I might catch it when I don't have to pay anything extra for it.
I got you.
Right. I just feel like we got enough of where the kids are fighting ghosts and all that, like Stranger Things. They didn't have to take it that direction, but I guess you got with the white guys, and then you had with the women. It was white guys. You had with the guys, and then you had one with the women. So now it's time to do one with the kids. I guess that's the thing, but maybe they could have did like a, they could have got a whole new job. They could have got a whole new set of people. Maybe they could have got some grown-ups, but man, like men and women, and put them together or did something like that. Or maybe like each like Ghostbusters had a nephew or something, or a niece, and they each kind of came together. I don't know. It's They got my man from Stranger Things. I'm like,
that's what I'm saying. If I want to watch Stranger Things, I'll watch Stranger Things. I don't want to watch Ghostbusters try to be Stranger Things.
Nah, they about to put them little Negroes in our face. All them Stranger Things kids, we gonna be watching for the next 10 years. Y'all saw the chick was in Godzilla. Like, nah, it was the dude, the little nerd kid was in Godzilla with the curly hair. I forget what the other girl
was. Oh, the chick is in Godzilla. L.
Oh yeah, them little kids is taking over, man. I'm like, holy smokes! Listen, he said, "Go watch damn Stranger Things, Hollywood. Stop casting them."
Stranger Things is great too. Like, don't you know? Get me wrong, I love that, but I don't need that in my Ghostbusters movie. I don't.
So the next one, we got the Mortal Kombat. It's like meet the cast. It's like. It's a little shorter than that Ghostbusters one, but I think it'll give us some behind the scenes looks, I guess, if y'all want. You know, look at that.
Oh, what's this one?
Mortal Kombat. Mortal Kombat!
We get that bitch on the 17th, I think it is. This month.
I'm ready, bro.
23rd.
I might have to go to the theaters to see that one too. I ain't gonna hold it.
Must be nice.
Right, bro. That's gonna sound bad. I just don't want to take my kids, bro.
I understand.
That's why I miss Eddie Griffin.
I really don't know if I should puff or pass this one. Y'all both puffing it?
Yeah, I'm a puff it. I should have passed on this Ghostbusters shit.
Right.
3 minutes of my life.
I'm kind of iffy on this one. I would pass it, but it sound like y'all both puffing it. So
why are you iffy?
They do it.
Tell people why you mad.
Remember how we was trying to figure out if Mortal Kombat gave us the best 30 seconds in the trailer last time we watched it?
Yeah.
I'm kind of just like, all right, Mortal Kombat, we'll see you when you get here.
I think this might be a little bit behind the scenes. I haven't seen this, so I don't know what we're getting.
Let's see how good it is.
All right.
Throughout history, different cultures all over the world reference a great tournament. That dragon marking? I think it's an invitation to fight for something known as Mortal Kombat.
I've always talked about respecting the material and respecting the fans. They all deserve to see their beloved characters elevated to this cinematic height.
This really comes across as a powerful experience that we haven't seen before. It's this grounded, dramatic, but violent tale.
What is so striking about Mortal Kombat is how expansive the story is. It's epic.
We have all the great characters that the fans love.
I'm Sonya.
Name's Jax.
That's Kano.
I'm Liu Kang.
Kung Lao.
Lord Raiden.
Scorpion.
I am Sub-Zero.
The interesting thing about playing a video game character is that you have to walk this line of being larger than life, but also making that person real.
There's actually rich emotional life behind every single character.
We need to be authentic. You need actors who can perform the actual movements and stunts.
It's mind-blowing what they do. And I think that fight element that has always been in the game can be brought to life on the screen. And it's not all CG, I promise you.
No matter how many of my people you put in the ground, we will not fail.
I've always believed that something elegant and beautiful can cohabitate with brutal and primal. All of the detail gives the audience a sense of realism and connectivity to this world.
The first time that I started seeing all of these guys in costume, I was blown away. They've completely brought all of these characters to life.
This is more than just seeing a movie produced. This is seeing something that I've been passionate about my whole life finally come to the screen.
I love working on this kind of international project.
It really represents the Mortal Kombat world.
hope it's both a reward for the fans and a new experience.
Don't be fooled that that's just a game. It's more than that. It's cinematic, it's beautiful, there's heart and there's emotion. All those ingredients together, it should be a fun, powerful ride. So enjoy.
Get over here!
Man, Jax is a bitch.
Bro, I almost fell asleep on that. I don't like that kind of stuff.
That's what I said. I don't know who was getting, but I was still
I like watching that. Like, I would, once I watch the movie, then I can go back and watch stuff like that and be like, oh, okay, yeah, oh, that's dope. Yeah, but you know what? I always, what Ron, what did you say about Jax?
He's disappointing every Mortal Kombat movie. Like, he's never holds it down.
I never liked to use Jax.
But look, it's like, maybe if they had more black characters, we wouldn't feel so strongly about his punk
ass. This is always been.
And they got the corniest black dude in Hollywood to play him. Nah, y'all got the wrong dude, man.
I don't know who that is.
He's the dude. Remember that movie? It was the meme went crazy where he was cheating on his wife.
Yeah.
That movie. And it was with the other girl.
He was a savage in that movie too, bro. That shit was crazy. Like, he stole all that lady money and everything. Wasn't that like a Tyler?
Oh, Perry? You're talking about Saving Grace. Yeah, he's in that too. That's
right. Yeah,
that's crazy.
But he's on, man. He came out, he had a little video on Facebook and he told like about Haiti, like the story of Haiti and how they fought for their liberation and everything, how the other countries just kind of turned their back on. That's the way. So it's a pretty good little video, man. I had some respect for Buddy after he did that. But Jax, my gripe with Jax is, why the black man got to be the one who get middle arms? Like, I because you remember like original Mortal Kombat, unless I'm just losing my mind, Jax didn't have middle arms. And then I don't know, bro. I feel like Jax, I feel like I played a Mortal Kombat before where he didn't have middle arms. Again, I could just be
on the skin.
It was like his regular arms, like regular Jax. He just had the pants on. But see, I always played with Jax because I just felt like as a black kid growing up, like I just had to pick the black guy. But I never liked this character. I never liked how they set Jax up. Like, I don't know. I almost wanted him to be cool, like Johnny Cage. Like why couldn't he be? I don't know. If a black man that powerful to be, I don't know. He should have had more like a Blade kind of feel to him. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, bro. They made Jax weird.
Exactly, like I said.
So, but I'm looking forward to this freaking movie, though. Do you hear me?
Oh, absolutely.
Do you hear me?
You hear him, Ron? You hear him?
I might send the whole... Matter of fact, Denny, you talking about going to the movies. That might either have to be the move for me, by myself, or I'm kicking everybody out the house. Everybody. Go with your mom-in-law. Go out.
Get out.
Get in the car and go. Take my card. Get. But I think the movie might be less expensive route to go.
Right. Get that car, boy. Woo.
Yeah, G ain't gonna watch this and be like, give me that card.
You're right. Don't watch this episode.
God.
Like, knowing my baby, she gonna take the card and stay home.
I decided I wanted to watch it on Amazon. So from here we got Loki 2.
Now that is an automatic. I can't believe we all puffed on Saw. This is an automatic all puff. But I heard some bad things about the trailer and how it ends.
I'm not puffing on this. I'm passing.
Ooh, why are you passing on Loki?
I'm just not really interested in Loki.
It's because he's white, huh?
You're a racist, bro.
I'm getting tired of people calling me a racist.
My last few trailers have been a miss. So I don't know.
I'm good.
Yeah, y'all off.
I'm gonna watch the movie now. Don't get me wrong, but I'm good on the show.
The Coffee and Kush.
The show. We, I don't even.
Ladies and lords, we apologize for JD and CJ's whack movie trailers that they put together. Because
the speakeasy with a CEO, and not only lie, but he would throw your ass under the bus while he lying.
Damn, it's just some of these podcast CEOs, boy.
Oh man,
more shade.
Don't do it to him.
Listen,
let's cue it up.
What are we queuing up, Loki?
Stop it. Get some help.
Oh, you puffing it? You're the deciding vote, JD.
I'm the deciding vote.
I'm passing. I already said it.
We ain't agree on one yet.
You know what? Yeah, go ahead and put it on. I got to use the restroom in.
Speaking of shit, I got to go take one.
That ain't right.
Y'all right. Boys be wildin',
bro. We might as well play his and Black Widow's back to back. Black Widow's look trash too. Well, nah, we'll break it down.
I know what this place is.
Now, Loki got the space though.
The timekeepers have built quite the circus. And I see the clowns are playing their parts to perfection. Big metaphor guy. I love it. Makes you sound super smart.
I am smart.
I know.
Okay.
Okay.
Please sign to verify this is everything you've ever said.
This is absurd.
Sign this too.
We protect the proper flow of time. You picked up the Tesseract breaking reality. I want you to help us fix it.
Why me?
I need your unique Loki perspective.
Do I get a weapon?
Nah.
Believe in this Loki variant?
Luckily, he believes in himself enough for the both of us. Bye.
It is adorable that you think you could possibly manipulate me. I'm 10 steps ahead of you.
You're not big on trust, are you?
You can't.
Loki, I've studied almost every moment of your entire life. You've literally stabbed people in the back like 50 times. Why never do it again?
Good over there? Ron is dying.
That thing must be good to him.
Boy. All right, we're going to get straight to
this. This John just made me pay for all my past sins. Ooh, I ain't never felt so much pain in my chest.
Yeah. All right. For the 2 seconds that I saw, I guess I'm watching it when it comes out. Or when it comes on.
I'm rock with it. All right, we're going to get straight to the Black Widow.
Bro, I was so high, I thought I was there with them.
We are there with them.
You don't know everything about me.
Writing it down.
I've lived a lot of lives.
Marvel Studios!
I was an Avenger. Before I got this family. I made mistakes. Choosing between what the world wants you to be. And who you are.
go back to where it all started.
Where did you think I was all this time?
We have unfinished business.
My girls are the toughest girls in the world.
I'm sorry. We had our orders and we played our roles.
It wasn't real.
It was real to me. To me? You were everything.
Bring her home.
Put your seatbelts on. She's such a mom. One thing's for sure. I'm done running from my past.
Gonna be in theaters for that too.
Yes, yes, and yes. That has been the best trailer we've watched so far. That's shit. There, yeah. I'm all the way invested in that. I need that. Right in my veins.
Why is everything Marvel putting out wag as hell?
That look wack too?
Boy, you stupid. Man, you stupid.
You too hot.
Now I hate to say I don't like to use that word. That's stupid.
You too hot.
WandaVision disappointed me. WandaVision hurt my heart. WandaVision. WandaVision hurt my heart. This Winter Soldier and whoever.
Hey, this shit about to be fire, man. Don't debate us.
I'm not all in. Loki, people are already coming at it. This junk, bro, I feel like it's like a decade too late.
Okay.
No disagreements, like
no.
She already died. First of all, she dies and then has a movie coming out.
This is setting up for her sister to come out as the next Black Widow.
Scarlett Johansson does not miss. Like her movies, her action movies she don't miss. I can't speak about none of the other stuff she do, but her action movies. She don't miss, and this trailer just proved that she continues to not miss. I cannot wait.
What was your favorite part about the trailer?
All of it.
The whole damn thing?
Knowing the date when I consume this content.
I mean, when I say it's whack, I'm like 8.5 out of 10 when I'm expecting 10 out of 10 from Marvel. You know, my biggest issue with what they've been doing, what I have issue with is the crossovers. Like, I should be seeing at least one other big superhero in everything. Everything. I don't know why we didn't get Doctor Strange or Captain Fantastic in Marvel Vision. Bruh, can y'all believe that the new Captain America is getting real life death threats?
Oh, I could believe it. People are so...
Steve Rogers is so pathetic. Everybody frustrated with this new show, but that's how Marvel do to start. And it don't look like no other superheroes in Black Widow. Like, come on, man. Where everybody at? They just chilling.
Learn about the new ones. They starting up Phase 4. They got to set up all the... Like I said, it's going to explain where his sister is. My sister's going to be the next Black
Widow. So, let me revise that. Since we on Marvel, JD, you said we couldn't talk about Winter Soldier. They did just plug a character at the end of the latest episode. Just say shout out to Wakanda. I know you didn't watch it yet. So, they do got some brewing. We'll see. CJ, are you caught up to it?
I already see the Wakanda crossover coming in. I already see that.
Okay, you saw that.
They showed it looked like a preview of some shit where old girl, one of the guards or whatever. I saw that, but that was from like the last episode.
Well, Marvel, you heard it here first. Step it up.
Yeah, so I got another trailer. It's called Monster. I don't know what it's about. It's got black people and it's coming on Netflix. It looks like it could be a good movie. I think we should puff on this. Just take a chance on this one. I don't know.
Pass!
That's a hard pass, bro.
JD, you ain't been hitting today.
All right, well, let me read the synopsis.
Dude, bro, come on now, dog. Come on, man.
Bro, play that one that I gave you. I guarantee you it's going to make you laugh. What's that joint called? Thunder Force. Just came out yesterday. I watched it last night.
I'm passing on that, too.
Oh, you know what? Hey, so on that movie, Monster, it got ASAP Rocky in it, and it got Nas in it.
Oh, all you got to say is Nas.
Yeah, you should have led with Nas.
I didn't know that. Like, I don't know shit about it.
CJ, how you going to pass on my movie, bro? Fuck you. CJ.
I'll pass on all those shit.
You just pass it because it's me.
So Monster was executive produced by Nas as well.
Speaking of Nas, RIP, DMX, bruh, Belly, JD, did you watch Belly or you remember it vaguely too?
I watched Belly. Shut up. Yeah, I watched Belly.
Oh, man.
Bro, this joint got to be vaguely.
Shots fired.
Hey, real quick,
you don't like the street genre. It's okay.
Real quick, y'all, I'm gonna run off this list real quick. So that movie Monster that y'all passed on, Jennifer Hudson's in it. Jeffrey Wright, this dude from Westworld.
Not you, bro. Jeffrey John Wright. David you gotta lead with that.
Bro, I didn't know it got John David Washington in it. Like, come on, bro.
He said Jeffrey Wright and Nas did something together. What?
Can I play the trailer?
Pass.
Nah, puff, 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 bong.
Go ahead, bro. Play the trailer, man. Play it. Go ahead.
Plead my case.
Go ahead. Let's see.
You might as well say it got DMX in it too. Shit.
I don't know.
What do you see when you look at me?
You ready for your test, right?
I just thought it.
Boy.
Images can tell a story. You have the opportunity here to move people.
Artist.
We came forward, running backwards.
Oh. Hey, yo, pull up.
Outsider.
Get my good side, hold up. You got me?
I got you, yo.
Somehow we made it.
When you were born, I thought of all the scenes of your life.
Although jaded,
dating a beautiful girl.
Was it worth it all?
Someone just like your mother?
Could it be more?
I even imagine being mad at you for things any kid does. But I never saw anything like this.
Failure.
All they see is another black man with a rap sheet.
Dog
looks the part to me.
No one has any idea who I am.
You can still do great things.
He's a monster.
Should one moment define my life?
So what did I think? Comes out May 7th, by the way, on Netflix. CJ said it's a snooze fest.
Nas ain't in that shit. You lied to me, nigga.
Hey, I just read what I read, bro. You saw Nas. He was in jail.
Are you delusional? Do you suffer from a mental illness?
No, I don't.
What? That'd be one the wife would have that one just on as I'm walking in the room. That ain't one I'm going to search for. I'm good on that.
Gotcha. Well,
that kid acting up. We're going to show him in a strong two-parent household and how you still can make mistakes. Get out of here with that. Are y'all quiet?
Huh? My bad, y'all. I'm in the middle of an argument. The missus is tripping as usual. Shout out to the queens. It must be that time of the cycle, you know, when they all start connecting.
Hey, she ran his kitchen, but she wants some breakfast.
Over here talking all that mansplaining. You about to get this how dare you assume she's on her period?
I don't have that much longer.
It's crazy how when women get together, they all connect and start going through things in the universe and charismas and karmas and connecting on different chakras. Blows my mind. Women are the
most breaking news, Denny. Buckhead has now begun the legal process to break away from Atlanta and become its own city.
Really?
Right.
Oh, I got the perfect instrumental to play for that.
Huh. Wonder why he's doing that.
It sounds like a up and coming Black Wakanda.
I don't even hear your music. I got you.
Shout out Christopher Wallace. Big bro. You saw how on Thursday for the Culture Corner, you shout out JD, John, Amon. That's the real JD, and we got JD number one over here. We're going to have to get creative.
Real JD and JD number one.
Hey, I'm older.
JD versus JD. Y'all stay tuned. The show JD versus JD is coming.
How old is JD?
35.
Damn. What the hell that got to do with anything?
He got it. He older.
Yeah, he got the name first. Would you call you JD Jr.?
Man, let me change this.
Hey, look, my son he texted me. He said, "Dad, can I get a headset for the PS4? And I sent him the meme for the gif of Charlie Murphy laughing.
You know what I'm talking about? Start talking to people, huh? Hey, that's a whole other animal out there, man. That online.
You know how many headsets my son done went through?
Oh, okay.
Crazy. Yeah, this ain't that first rendezvous, bro. This would be like headset number 5. I'm good on it.
Crazy part about playing online, like, them little keyboard warriors, they quick to drop the hard
enough. Oh, yeah.
You know what you should do? Just get him a little cheap pair of the regular normal headphones. Get it a decent pair, $20 pair. Use those for the meantime. I think about it. Let's see you take care of these.
Uncle Ron, you sending me $20? I'm going to text him right now.
Get your $10 pair. You know what, CJ? At the end of this episode, we doing a $25 giveaway. You win it. You got it.
You're right. I don't work for the show, so I'm good for
it. JD, play that. Was you playing that Kanye beat?
Yeah.
You know, I was just thinking the other day how much I miss the old Kanye. Y'all imagine it. 007 Kanye never left our life.
I can testify to that.
This song make me sad. We had the Jesus Walk Kanye, man. They stole that man from us.
Yeah. It was just the perk. I guess, you know, he was there when you needed him. When you needed him. Yeah, that music is
that trajectory. The trajectory of his life is insane. It's more wild than the kings in the Bible and how they go through their ups and downs.
It's when you go back and listen to Gold Digger. It's freaking hilarious now. Like how his life, you know, how it ended for him. Well, not ended, but how it is like now. It's like, were you talking about yourself, bro?
My man became a Kardashian.
Not anymore.
Oh.
He's free. Brother Kanye is free. Fellas. All right, let's play. Let's play the trailer. Let's play the toilet.
Put
the toilet.
Video. Huh? You want to play it? I can play it if you want.
Yeah, because Ron ain't listening. He in trouble. He already know.
Right.
He, soon as he walk out that door, his wife going to be waiting right there with the bill. He in trouble. He in his...
I don't know. Oh, go ahead, baby. Beat me.
10 o'clock was the last.
Beat me, baby. Beat me.
It's so good.
Oh man.
I'm surviving. And here we go.
We are not here yet.
Yes, we are. Yes, we are.
How do we go from movie trailers to this?
No.
We are here.
I thought this was the end of the show.
Right, we're here. Let's go.
Oh, we done skipped through everything.
They look so good. Oh my goodness. Who taught you to cook like this?
Your daddy.
Your daddy did that?
Your daddy! Oh my goodness. Your daddy! I want to talk to your
daddy! Crazy. Are you going to add extra cheese on the back of that?
Look at the back of that motherfucker.
Yeah. Extra cheese,
just add some cheese on the corner too. Put some cheese on it.
Yeah.
Oh. This is crazy great. I had no idea that you could actually make a smoker out of a toilet.
No, out of the think tank.
This is
there's no thinking
I've ever seen in my life.
That ain't goo. That's dude.
So
dude.
I see it's kind of brown. Did you see
it's brown kind of shit, baby.
Hey,
yeah. Yeah.
I don't get white people.
Bruh, they got a cop there. But he got it. They need to stop that.
That's nasty. Yeah.
Oh, bruh. I laugh so hard. That is disgusting, though. That's freaking disgusting. I don't give a flying flip if you just went and bought that toilet brand new from Lowe's and decided to do that with it. I fresh out the stove. That's still disgusting. Why don't you just get a smoker? Just go get a smoker.
That shit nasty.
I would think it would take more work to rig a toilet to do that than to just go get a smoker. Ryan, you a chef. What's the least inexpensive smoker you can get? What you can get a smoker for, bro? A good one.
Oh, free.
Just unplug.
They literally just showed that you can use any damn thing for a smoker. There's so many different custom homemade smokers that I
don't know. Talk to your dad.
What that was just something they had to be sitting around smoking on their version of coffee and kush. Maybe shit and stank. But they just was like, let's turn the toilet into a smoker.
Yuck.
Y'all gonna talk about Westworld or y'all saving it for next week? I don't think you can wait another week. We just got all hella off script, man. I can't. See, my man, listen, I gotta go back to the lineup now. Y'all done threw off the whole vibe.
Ryan, you ain't been to the lineup in a minute.
I want to say the lineup is an ever evolving thing. That's all.
So, ladies and loyal, last week, episode 7, shout out EP, who scheduled a trip on Coffee and Kush time. We know what you've been up to, man. Birthday boy last week, Shout out to him. Go watch that episode. Episode 7. Westworld episode 1.
Shit. Shout out to Publix.
Reaction. JD greedy as hell.
I'm hungry, man. Y'all boys playing. I got breakfast to eat.
We did that. You know what I'm looking forward to most on our Coffee and Kush YouTube page once we get it up and running? JD, you gonna help me run it, right? Is we got so many different segments that we done did. Like, we can post Westworld season 1 review as its own video, and then we'll do part 2, then we'll do part 3. We done did shit like our Avengers breakdown. We broke down all of the Avengers. Was that episode 4? Yo, go watch that. We done been putting out some legendary clips.
So much footage.
Like, we're going to go back and chop it up and edit. And then we still got all the behind-the-scenes episodes that we done did. Like, our first episode when we did like a two-hour session before we went live.
Just let the tape run.
We going to bless y'all. That's why, shout out to the elite of the Coffee and Kush Facebook page. Y'all go follow that. All right. So, all of that leads up into all that just to say, it's time for... I don't even got it ready.
Shame on you.
I'm slacking as usual. But let me get the screen share.
Is that the Grey Goose behind you? The Goosey Goose?
The Goose.
Ooh. They say the goose gets you loose. That's what they say.
The goose don't get me started. I don't got nothing ready.
We
My
know.
Bad, ladies and royals.
You know.
My bad.
They didn't even have a link ready. Shit. Why we expect anything else, Ron?
Oh, man.
Hey, I look forward to potting with y'all boys Saturday morning.
This will be fun. Right. Saturday mornings.
We supposed to be potting in the morning. Y'all ones be potting hella late. Don't give me that.
I'm about to balk off on y'all.
Well, then we need to set a stop dead time, CJ. If you want to get that way and act like you're in your feelings, like you got somewhere to go, all up in the video dancing.
We always say 1:30, but that shit be missing that mark. Big time. Listen,
you see, we're at an hour mark, technically.
Listen. Yeah. And we've been on here for 2 hours at minimum. And Ron's wife is texting. She like, boy, if you don't hurry your ass up. I know what she's texting you, bro. Don't play. He got breakfast.
Ain't
to cook.
Nobody worried about nobody that got a vagina in between their legs. You know what I'm talking about? Women. I'm going to say something. In 2021, y'all need to sit down. CJ, I got a couple women's questions to ask you once we get into this Westworld season 2 breakdown, which is going to take at least 30 minutes. So just get ready to have something to puff because we really about to digest on this Westworld season.
Oh, no, we ain't got that.
30 who? Hold on.
Hey, I'll leave my screen up, but you can talk to the coffee and the fish behind me.
Oh, man.
Oh, come on, man. We only get one Saturday a month. A week.
A month? It's only one Saturday a week? How many Saturdays is there a week, bro?
This fruit. No. My fruit is
about... All my Saturdays.
Go bad.
My Sabbath day.
I dreamt I was on an ocean.
Come on, man.
Westworld season 2, baby. CJ just finished it.
And the others on the distant shore.
You just playing just in trailer, right?
I've been watching for 2 years.
No.
What's it mean?
Dreams don't mean anything, Dolores. That answer doesn't seem to satisfy you.
Because it's not completely honest. Did you ever stop to wonder about your actions? Price you'd have to pay if there was a reckoning. That reckoning is here.
point, the stakes were never real. But now, you and the rest of your kind are free.
She's something we programmed. She's not real.
You're going to take me to my daughter. Here we are. Kind that will never know death. And yet we're fighting to live. There is beauty in what we are.
We've ridden 10 miles and all we've seen is blood. Is this really what you want?
It's us or them. Revenge is just a different prayer at their altar, darling.
They wanted a place hidden from God. We had something else in mind entirely. I'm gonna burn this whole thing to the ground.
You're lost in the dark.
Oh, God, world.
I know exactly what is out there.
Westworld season 2 is fucking nuts, man.
Why on earth would you ever be frightened of me?
No matter how much you want to critically acclaim Westworld, regardless to how you feel, every second of Westworld is literally effing nuts.
Yeah, it was good.
Always out of control.
It was good the first season, but it was good.
Right, it wasn't good as the first season, but not many shows as good as that first season was. Like, it's. Yeah. It was almost no way it was going to be able to be as good as the first season. It still was.
You know what pisses me off? You know what it's like? It's like LeBron James. Like, LeBron James has made it to NBA championships his entire NBA career. But since he's never been like Jordan and won them all, and he's come short just a little bit, a couple of times, everybody wants to critically acclaim him because of the longevity and continuing it.
Okay, I don't know where LeBron came in at, but
my man's doing some profound shit.
Right. He's feeling good. He really made it. He really made it left at Mars. I told you, boy. I don't know where he at, but
it's about to be.
I was trying to rock with you, but I was like,
where is he going with this?
Yeah, I was trying to see how you gonna tie that.
I kind of lost it too. You know, like we're up in space. Hey.
me and talk, he was like, what the hell am I doing?
just keep it going. You know, the water
blue. See, season two was freaking dope. It was awesome. I enjoyed it. I thought it led up. I thought it continued the story very, very well. I loved the ending. Every episode, like you say, bro, it's just freaking nuts. Like, it kept my attention the entire time. It was a great continuation of the first season. Like, and it was everything I hoped that it could be. Wasn't really any parts where I was like, eh. Now I will say it did kind of get a little slow to me in the samurai town, kind of doing the whole love thing. I wish it could have been a little bit more action there, even though it still was a ton of action. But it was pretty cool, like, to kind of see their doppelgangers and be like, y'all really didn't even try that hard to come up with a new story. But I thought it was pretty.
Are you rocking with Dolores' cause?
Huh?
You rocking with Dolores' cause?
I'm rocking with all that shit, bro. Like, burn it to the ground. One thing, though, Ron had me shot. Like, I asked this man, I say, like, is this futuristic? Like, based on the future? No, this is like it could be next year. I'm like, bro, get the fuck out of here. You know ain't no shit like that in next year. Like, what? Come on, dog. Like, you just be lying.
Bro, they talking about Elon Musk being able to build Jurassic Park.
What you mean?
I don't know.
Bro, there is clones among us. Stop tripping, CJ.
Nigga, you a clone.
Yeah, you're on a clone this morning. He asked, well, this afternoon, he had in brand new.
Right along with Gucci Mane.
But you know what I meant, bro. Like, futuristic kind of movies. You thought next year. Come on, bro. You know exactly what I meant.
No, lost me. So I want to break down the characters of Westworld 2, because the transition from season one to season two. JD, how you just gonna throw something on as soon as I throw something on?
Oh, you got something on? Oh. Hey, I was trying to do my job, dog, you know?
And I got a slapper.
Can't say that.
But that's not the instrumental. Damn. My bad. Our video gonna get taken down.
Damn, Ron.
But let me tell you this. We ain't go this whole time for this motherfucker to be taken down. If this one get taken down.
Never mind. I got it, JD. I got it. So, like Dolores, for instance, she goes from completely affectionate, we feel everything from her, to cold heart killing murderer in season two. A lot of people didn't like that. The Shogun world that you, John, that you was talking about, that kind of was like its own just little random filler. They didn't make that a part of the whole scheme of the whole season. People didn't like that. My favorite part of the entire season, yo, these damn dogs is gonna drive me crazy. Is they loud? Can y'all hear them?
Yeah, I can hear them.
Can y'all hear my kids above me?
No.
They make a noise.
They going nuts.
Hey!
You crying them? Uh oh. What was your dog name? Daisy, Delilah. What was your dog name?
Pepper.
Dolores.
Is it Pepper?
Pepper. There it is.
Yo, this moment, CJ. Did this not blow your mind? When all of this came to fruition and you saw that he pretty much was a robot who they tried to give everlasting life to.
And he that was nuts. Cause I kept one, let me tell you, when I'm watching it, right? And then when the second time, you know, they showed him again, I was like, now I know I'm feeling real good. I'm feeling excellent, but I know I ain't that fucked up. I know I done seen this. So I went back and actually like rewinded it and was like, okay, oh, I'm not crazy. Then I went back because sometimes the internet be tripping, man. You know, I got this new Ron internet. This shit. Yeah. But anyway, but yeah, so when I realized it was a loop and I realized what was going on, especially, and they kind of get you again, like when they show how long he's been going there to see him, like since he was a young man, and they kind of hit you with that whole time thing again. You almost had the same feeling like when you found out that Billy or William was the man in black. So I thought that was pretty dope.
Yeah.
Destroy this bill. How they burn that motherfucker? I'm like, dad, you can't just erase it, bro. Gotta burn it up. You know how much money you wasting?
So season one, you kind of had the overall realization that this is a comparison of black people, these robots, and the struggle and whatnot that we go through. How did that transition into season two? Like, what was your overall outlook on the show?
My overall outlook on the show was the robots get ready to take this mother flipper over. Nothing we can do. I didn't like that that Maeve had to die. Like,
Maeve.
Like, at the end, like, I wasn't feeling it. I wasn't feeling her ending.
How did her ending go? I don't remember that.
Right, she died. Then she, like, at the end, she was...
What'd she do? How'd it go?
Well, she's in season three, so I didn't want to be a spoiler.
Okay, but... well, they must be trying to bring her back then, because, like, she died, like, watching her daughter escape, like, through that tunnel, like,
Through the Great Valley Beyond.
Yeah, through the Great Valley Beyond. When you see them, they jump through, and they, like... They a part of them goes across and then like the other form.
They go to heaven.
Right. They go to heaven. So and then that but then like when I didn't like that she didn't get there. Like I like
oh she got shot, right?
Right. I didn't like
that. Yeah, she didn't make it to the Great Valley Beyond. Right.
I didn't like that.
She's not in the desert.
So she's still around. She didn't get to go be free.
Yeah, I didn't like that. I would have rather her got on the train at the end of season one to keep it moving. Bring her back. Because you were right, like, well, I could because, you know, she becomes your favorite character. I want to see more of her being able to control the people around her.
Who, Dolores?
Yeah, not Dolores. I want to, yeah. But I'm interested, though, bro. I'm looking forward to season three. I started it, and then my CEO told me I had to stop. Well, I was fired, so I stopped. I'm looking forward to seeing Marshawn Lynch. I heard he was in it.
Yeah,
gonna be pretty cool. But everybody's telling me that season three is a drop off, severe drop off from the first two. So I hope that's not the case.
I liked it just because I enjoyed the story and the scene. I'm still interested to see what's up. But I mean, I can see.
So, My thoughts is, like I said, it's nuts.
How my dude knew? He knew that she was Dolores at the end. He was like, my job is to protect the robots inside the park, not outside. And he got like, and I was like, oh, he knows that. It was, wow.
It was nuts. When she changed her body.
Now, see, I like that. Now, when I kind of, because I watched a few minutes of season three, she was back to being Dolores. So I guess there's a point. Are they going to talk about that? How she went from the black body back to the
master plan. You're going to see a master plan.
So it's going to be two Dolores in that thing.
You have no idea. Huh? You just like, what is about to happen?
Now I was very excited when you know, the Dolores came out in her body, and then Bernard says, like, you want to live forever, you get your chance, and he shot him. That black chick, though, she was dope, bro. Like, the human her, she was dope. Like, she was brave, and like, she was, I don't know what was driving her. I hope they kind of give you a little bit of her story this season three. If not, you know, it is what it is. But like, she was like a freaking savage, dog. And the whole, and be honest with you, I kind of thought she was gonna end up being a machine. I thought she was gonna be a machine. And then how mind-blowing it was that they had a machine for her. And then, so I guess that's how it is, right? For everybody who comes to the park, they make it like a copy of you. Is that how it was? Like in the back, but that shit crazy. So you gonna release all them copies onto the world?
You know what it's like? How you saying it couldn't happen tomorrow is literally just like our version of social media. Everybody that's on it, a copy of them gets made. All your information, all your data. Once you enter this world, you ain't getting out. We got you. Shout out Mark Zuckerberg.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, let's get one hand. He finally landed one. That's what I'm talking about, right? You finally landed right.
So, speaking of people that thought they was robots, Man in Black, he shot his own daughter.
He shot his daughter!
Thinking she was fake. And by the end of the season, he's having contemplations cutting himself open because he just lost it.
Because he doesn't know what's real and fake anymore. He doesn't know. He's so paranoid.
Too much.
So you wanted to talk
why she was in there. I was questioning why she was making shit up. But I said, this dude is freaking nuts. But when you spend that much time in that world, I mean, he went from shit, we'll say our age, to being an old ass man.
30, 40 years in that park, every damn day, like he crazy. And that's why we saw his family was nuts too. His wife killed herself. What'd you think about, remember how we was talking about him and his brother-in-law's relationship? You got to see how that relationship transpired. His brother went nuts.
In season right, he went nuts, like the park drove him mad.
Yeah.
And he was able like to step in.
Kid sitting out the family cookout just outside.
Bro, let me tell you this. The Man in Black is the ultimate simp. You lost your all because you fell in love with Dolores. See, I can't relate to stuff like this, bro.
$1 billion wife.
You got
worried about a robot.
Dog, you chasing robot?
What? It's like that clip JD played last week. What did he say? Hey, Dolores, honey, I ain't never coming back home.
Come back bye. No more. I just can't understand how, now having an obsession with the park and all that, but ain't no robot cheeks in the world good enough to turn down no $1 billion cheeks in real life, bro.
Look at that, robot cheeks.
He didn't, he chasing robot cheeks and like,
But you see how invested he was, because you gotta look at what happened to his father. So he did have other aspirations, you know, trying to figure out the maze. And everlasting life too at the same time.
But it seems like he had a plan to almost destroy the park. Like, I don't get it. I don't understand his motive. I guess when you go mad, there is no rhyme or reason, huh? But
yeah,
when
I saw this man, outlook and setup of the park is kind of what he is. Like, his inside. Like, it's just chaos because the decision's made, and that's just what the park is.
Let me tell you this, bro. I get mad at my children, but I could never kill one of my kids. I don't.
JD, how you ain't watch Westworld 1 and 2? You know we doing these recaps. JD ain't ready.
He have watched them.
I haven't seen it. I thought I need to go back and rewatch it. I've seen it.
JD don't remember a damn thing that happened on Westworld.
That man got shot.
Name something that happened in season 2, JD.
I've been talking.
All right, so let's get out of here.
Fantastic.
CJ saved this moment, but I don't want to keep it going too long because y'all got stuff to do. Do y'all feel like feminism is killing entertainment?
What do you mean?
Women empowerment on TV, kind of like the direction of how Westworld went. That was my feeling of watching season 2.
No, I have another feeling that I have that's trying to dominate TV that in entertainment that I don't like.
Oh, man.
It's a whole nother narrative I can speak, but no, I don't mind watching like women having the lead roles, women, you know, taking charge and women doing that, man. That don't bother me. It's a whole nother narrative that I have a problem with, which is one of the reasons why I'm still so, like, this show is so intriguing to me, because hasn't been a lot of that. I'm pretty sure y'all know what I'm talking about. Right. So that's why I'm liking it. Friday, what are we talking about? Let's go. We done.
This is gonna be real quick. It's a game that I came up with. This is called Movie Review Time. Whatever. I ain't come up with a name with it. Fuck it. What y'all gotta do is I'm gonna give y'all 3 movies.
Came up with a name? No, I didn't.
Y'all gotta give the review of the movie in 30 seconds. Of what the whole movie was about in 30 seconds. And if you do it, remember, you're gonna be the Kush King of the day. CJ, are you ready to go first? Do I have any volunteers? I got the stopwatch ready.
No, you go first. You go first. It's okay.
No, I got the stopwatch. Y'all want to go? Come on. Come on.
I'll go.
JD, step up to the plate, man. I'm mad EP ain't here. CJ don't ever want to do anything. All right. Describe the whole movie of Friday in 30 seconds, JD. Ready, set, go.
So the movie Friday is about the day Friday, two homeboys get into some shit with the local drug dealer. You got Smokey and Craig. It's just the trial and tribulation they go through on the front porch of, you know, another day in the hood of, I think it was in Compton. We're going to say Compton. I don't know where it was at. There's a neighborhood bully. He gets beat up and Craig gets the cheeks. The end.
I did it. That was a hella good job. I'm impressed. I thought you was going to get lost. Oh, let me get the applause.
Who's king of the week?
Like, I get the fuck out of here.
CJ, I got an easy one for you. Come on, step up to the challenge.
Let's go.
You got this. Coming to America. 30 seconds. You ready?
I am.
Go, motherfucker.
African prince wakes up one day and decides that he want to buck on his daddy. So he set up to be married to, it's an arranged marriage. So he comes to America, to Queens, New York, and he finds his queen, and they go through some problems and tribulations along the way. But then eventually they go back to his hometown in Africa and they get married and they live happily ever after. And it was a great sequel that came behind it. Boom.
Oh, 23 seconds. He just stole the championship from you, JD. Beat your 26 seconds at the grasp of defeat. All right, let me see if I can beat 23 seconds. I ain't prepared. I ain't cheat. This is all off the dome. So, CJ, when I beat you, 20 all seconds.
Hold on now. I got to stop watching. Hold on. You're cheating. Hold on.
I got to get this
started. Can you see that? Okay.
Tell me when to go.
And go.
Love and Basketball. Two childhood kids, boy and girl, grew up playing basketball their entire life together. Fell in love in high school, ended up going to the same college together. Broke up horrifically, went their own ways in the NBA and the WNBA. Ended up getting back together, building a beautiful family. Love and Basketball.
All
right. Less than 50 seconds.
19.
Oh! Yeah. Give me my crown.
You ain't getting shit.
In the $25 giveaway, the very end of the show, name the three movies that we did our 30-second fast pass on. I love that. Coffee and Kush, ladies and gentlemen. Fellas, y'all got anything before we get out of here?
Now, just shout out to the best fans not on earth. Shout out to the fellas. Again, shout out to EP.
Ladies and loyals, the three movies that we did... Write them to the Coffee and Kush Facebook group chat. Follow us. We coming on all platforms soon. Best show not on earth. Boy, I love what we do.